ओके सो आई वाज टेलिंग यू दैट सबसे पहले कौन सी एक्ट आई, दैट वाज द रॉलेट एक्ट इन 1919. ओके देन आफ्टर दैट दिस जलियांवाला बाग मैसेकर हैपेंड इन दैट एंड खिलाफत एजिटेशन वाज गोइंग ऑन. सो दैट रिजल्टेड इनटू द नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट. गांधी जी सॉ द चांस दैट he could unite the Hindus and Muslims. So then he started the non-cooperation movement. Okay. So in that non-cooperation movement, Gandhiji believed only in non-violent methods. Okay. He always believed that independence should be attained by non-violent methods. Why he was so much inclined towards the non-violence methods? Because he had a vision. उनका एक अपना अलग vision था that in future also that if Indians will get the rule of India and when they will rule India and they will run the government, so that time this non-violent method should be there in every field. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट बाई हुक और क्रूक की कैसे भी धक्का मुक्की करके धोखीधड़ा से मार पीट के अपने हक ले लो. सो ही वॉज नॉट इन दैट नोशन. उनके बिलीव अलग थे. ही ऑलवेज बिलीव इन नॉन वायलेंस. सो ही दे बिलीव, उनको लगता था कि अगर हम अभी लड़ मर के अगर हम फ्रीडम लेंगे तो आगे भी ऐसे ही चलता रहेगा. सो अगर इन फ्यूचर अगर कोई एक्सप्लोटेशन हो रही है सो देन पीपल विल यू नो इट विल दे विल डू द सेम थिंग एज इट वॉज डन बिफोर. So that's why his vision was very different. He always believed in non-violence methods that if you want to get something, it should be attained in by non-violent methods. Okay, so that's why you can say some people, you know, they like Mahatma Gandhi and some people do not like Mahatma Gandhi. So it is their own perspective. So it is not like that we got independence only because of Mahatma Gandhi ji or only because of Bhagat Singh. ठीक है, बिकॉज एवरी पर्सन हु इज रिलेटेड विद इंडियन हिस्ट्री दे हैड देयर ओन पर्सपेक्टिव्स. उनके अपने अपने पर्सपेक्टिव थे. किसको रेवोल्यूशनरी मेथड अच्छा लगता था, किसी को नॉन वायलेंस अच्छा लगता. आई विल कीप माय वीडियो ऑफ बिकॉज आई थिंक देयर इज बैंडविड्थ इज लिटिल लो. इट वाज हैपनिंग इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आल्सो. इट इज अ रियल स्टोरी व्हिच हैज हैपेंड सो वी मस्ट नो अबाउट इट. Okay, so I'm telling you that people in Indian history, they had their own perspectives. Unki apni apni perspectives the, kaam karne ke liye unka mood of struggle alag alag tha. And it is not only ki ek person ki wajah se hume azadi mil gayi hai. So it was a combined effort of so many persons, of so many parties that we were able to gain the independence. So it is on you that whether you want to like it or not, but I will just tell you the perspectives of all the persons. ठीक है कि हर person के क्या क्या perspective थे, गांधी जी का क्या methods थे, भगत सिंह के क्या methods थे, but then it's on you that whether you want to support anyone or not. Okay, but at least you must know about their perspectives. So I was telling you that non-cooperation movement, which was initiated by Mahatma Gandhi ji, it gained momentum. It became intense through 1921 and 22. So how it happened? So Gandhi ji believed in non-violence. वो चाहते थे कि violence ना हो कहीं पे भी. So it is only through non-violence that people should show non-cooperation movement ki just they should say that we will not cooperate with the Britishers. ठीक है. बाकी और means they he never wanted that people should indulge in the non-violent methods. So how did this movement, this non-cooperation movement unfolded in steps? People took in their own perspectives. Logon ko kya laga ki Mahatma Gandhi ne non-cooperation movement start kar diya. Now they started participating in their own manners. Unhone apne tarike se uspe means they started participating. So what happened in that? Thousands of students left government controlled school colleges. Yes. So how did people reacted in this? How did people participate? Thousands of students left government-controlled schools and colleges. उन्होंने जो British-controlled school colleges से वहाँ पे जाना छोड़ दिया, बंद कर दिया. Many lawyers such as Motilal Nehru, C. R. Das, Raja Gopalachari, Asif Ali, they gave up their practices. So because these courts were of the Britishers, Britishers के courts होते थे, उन्होंने वहाँ पे जाके अपनी practice बंद कर दी. British titles were surrendered. So the special titles like Ravindranath ji ko knighthood ka title diya tha unhone, okay, sir ka title diya tha. So that was also surrendered by the Indian people that you know, we don't want any favor from you people, you just leave our India. And the legislators were also boycotted, means they did not want to participate in any of the elections. Unhone elections mein mana kar diya ki nahin, we will not participate in your elections, we want complete independence. So people lit public bonfires of foreign clothes. जो भी उनके प्रोडक्ट्स होते थे, फॉरेन क्लोथ होते थे, उनको जला दिया उन्होंने. सो दे शोड देयर अग्रेशन, दे शोड देयर नॉन कोऑपरेशन बाय दिस. बट ऑल दिस वाज मेयरली द टिप ऑफ द आइसबर्ग. लार्ज पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री वर ऑन द ब्रिंक ऑफ अ फॉर्मिडेबल रिवोल्ट. सो यू कैन से दैट दिस नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट वाज जस्ट, यू कैन से, यू नो व्हाट इज आइसबर्ग? आइसबर्ग इज समथिंग, it is a mountain of ice which is inside the sea. So it is, you can say more than 90% of the iceberg is underwater. Only the tip, you can say 1% of the tip is which is seen on the above the sea surface. So that it was just the tip of the iceberg. ये जो non-cooperation movement start हुई थी, जो लोगों ने participate शुरू करना शुरू किया, so that was just the tip of the iceberg. But large parts of the country, they were on the edge of this formidable revolt. Formidable means very intense revolt. So means lot has to be done. कि बहुत कुछ अभी करना था. This was just the beginning in that time. This non-cooperation movement. Okay. So then Gandhiji, what happened in this? Gandhiji's idea of non-cooperation movement was only Swaraj. Swaraj means self-help. So they wanted complete independence and they wanted to use their own products only. But different classes and groups, they had interpreted Gandhiji's call in their own manner. But logon ne kya kiya? Logon ne is non-cooperation movement ko apne tarike se shuru kar diya. Means they started working in their own benefit, just for their own benefits. Like agar wo zamindars ke exploit ho rahe hain by the zamindars, so then they started non-violent campaigns shuru kar di unhone. ठीक है. एंड सो दे स्टार्टेड वॉयलेंट मेथड्स विच गांधी जी नेवर वॉन्टेड. गांधी जी को कभी नॉन वॉयलेंट मेथड नहीं चाहिए थे. सो पीपल, डिफरेंट क्लासेस एंड ग्रुप्स, दे इंटरप्रेटेड गांधी जी कॉल इन देयर ओन मैनर विच वॉज नॉट इन अकॉर्डेंस विद हिज आइडियाज. सो गांधी जी आइडियाज वर लाइक ही वॉन्टेड peaceful protest, okay, he wanted non-violence movement, but in Kheda, Patidar peasants organized non-violent campaigns against high land revenue demand of the British. So, logon ne kya karna shuru kar diya? They started organizing non-violent campaigns. Unhone non-violent campaigns start kar diye. In coastal Andhra and Tamil Nadu, liquor shops were picketed. Picketed means they started demolishing the liquor shops and they stopped people from going into the liquor shops. Okay, that happened. Then in the Guntur district of Andhra Pradesh, tribals and poor peasants staged a number of forest satyagrahas. Unko forcefully they had to work. प्लांटेशन में उनको फोर्सफुली काम करना पड़ता था. एंड फॉरेस्ट में भी उनको एंटर नहीं करते थे. वो फॉरेस्ट एक्ट लगा दिए थे उन्होंने कि ये हमारा एरिया है, इफ यू वांट टू डू ग्रेजिंग और कटिंग देन यू हैव टू टेक परमिशन फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिशर्स. सो ट्राइबल पीपल ने, पुअर पीजेंट्स ने, उन्होंने क्या कर दिया अपने एनिमल्स को? दे यूज टू सेंड देयर एनिमल्स इन टू द फॉरेस्ट फॉर द ग्रेजिंग बट विदाउट पेइंग द ग्रेजिंग फी. अदरवाइज दे हैड टू पे द ग्रेजिंग फी. बट दे showed their involvement in this non-cooperation movement in their own ways by using these forceful methods. But so that's why it was a different interpretation. Means Gandhiji never wanted this. Gandhiji ko ye nahi chahiye tha. He always believed in non-violence, but people had interpreted Gandhiji's call in their own manner. So और जैसे नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट और खिलाफत मूवमेंट, इट कंबाइन. एंड इन सिंध, पाकिस्तान एंड बंगाल, मुस्लिम ट्रेडर्स थे जो, दे वर वेरी एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट द खिलाफत कॉल. आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट खिलाफत एजिटेशन. सो जो मुस्लिम ट्रेडर्स एंड पीजर्स, दे वर एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट दिस. एंड पंजाब में व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग दैट टाइम, द अकाली एजिटेशन. एजिटेशन मींस दैट डिस्टर्बेंस, दैट प्रोटेस्ट. सो अकाली एजिटेशन ऑफ द सिक्स सॉट टू रिमूव करप्ट महंत्स. हु वर महंत्स? महंस आर द रिलीजियस लीडर्स. देखे जो रिलीजियस लीडर्स होते हैं जिनको लोग बहुत मानते हैं, ओके, लाइक आर स्वामी जी इज ऑल्सो देयर. सो दे आर फ्रॉम महंत फैमिली. सो उस टाइम पे क्या होता था दैट ये जो महंस होते थे वो करप्ट होते थे एंड दे वर सपोर्टिंग ब्रिटिशर्स. ओके, सो द अकाली एजुटेशन ऑफ द सिक्स सॉट टू रिमूव करप्ट महंस सपोर्टेड बाय द ब्रिटिश फ्रॉम द गुरुद्वारा. सो दैट टाइम दीज महंस हु वर mixed with the British, they were stealing money from the Gurudwaras and they were giving it to the Britishers, and in turn Britishers were rewarding the Mahants for this act. So this made the Akali people, who were religious people, who were attached, who were linked with these Gurudwara committees, they were very agitated about this. So they wanted to remove these corrupt Mahants. Okay, so what was happening? So this was done, and this was also done by non-violence methods. Then participation by tea garden laborers in Assam had their own notion. ठीक है, जो गार्डन लेबरर्स होते थे, प्लांटेशन करते थे, जो टी प्लांटेशन होती थी, इनको फोर्सफुली दे हैड टू वर्क अंडर द ब्रिटिशर्स, ठीक है, उनको कहीं भी दे डिड नॉट लेट देम गो आउटसाइड, उनको बाहर कहीं जाने नहीं देते थे, उनका कोई टाइमिंग नहीं था, दे ऑलवेज हैड टू वर्क अंडर द ब्रिटिशर्स इन दैट प्लांटेशन. सो वेन दे ऑल started supporting Mahatma Gandhi ji, but in their own ways, and they used to raise slogans Gandhi Maharaj ki jai. So they all supported Gandhi ji, they used to consider him like a god, but Gandhi ji never wanted non-violent methods. ठीक है, सो पीपल का परसेप्शन क्या बना तब उस टाइम पे, गांधी जी इज अ काइंड ऑफ मसीहा. सो लोगों को लगता था कि गांधी जी एक मसीहा की तरह है एंड वो हमें हर चीज से बचाएंगे. ठीक है, सो बट गांधी जी ही विश्ड टू बिल्ड क्लास यूनिटी, नॉट क्लास कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. क्लास यूनिटी मीन्स इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट कि जो जमींदार्स थे वो फार्मर्स को एक्सप्लॉइट करते थे, बट जमींदार्स वर ऑल्सो इंडियन पीपल. सो गांधी जी वॉन्टेड दैट देयर शुड बी क्लास यूनिटी. क्लास यूनिटी मीन्स इंडियन पीपल. क्लास मीन्स इंडियन क्लास, द पीपल हु वर ऑल इंडियंस. There should be unity among all Indians, whether rich class or poor class, whether zamindars or laborers, and not class conflict. Conflict means ki aisa nahi hai ki Indian log apne mein hi aapas mein ladte bhirte rahe aur marte jaye. They need to understand that all the Indian, they had to unite and they had to fight against one power, that is British power. So he wished to build class unity, wo banana chahte the, not class conflict. But फिर भी पीजेंट्स को लगता था, येट पीजेंट्स कुड इमेजिन दैट ही वुड हेल्प देम इन देयर फाइट अगेंस्ट जमींदार्स. लोगों के अपने परसेप्शन थे, उनको लगा कि गांधी जी हमारे मसीहा हैं, वो तो हमें जमींदारों से बचाएंगे, हमारा जो लैंड है वो हमें वापस दिलवाएंगे. सो एंड एग्रीकल्चर लेबरर्स ऑल्सो बिलीव ही वुड प्रोवाइड देम लैंड, बट दिस वॉज नॉट दैट थिंग. उनको अपना परसेप्शन लगा, दे इंटरप्रेटेड, दे अंडरस्टूड लाइक दिस, बट एक्चुअली इट वॉज नॉट लाइक दैट. So he, Gandhi ji's ka, unka perception tha that he believed in non-violent methods and he wanted the unity of Indian people against the Britishers. So ordinary people credited Gandhi ji with their own achievements. Agar us time pe any achievement that ordinary people could get, they always credited Gandhi ji. Agar wo apne dam pe bhi koi achievement lete the, that one case was there, that peasants of Pratapgarh, they managed to stop illegal eviction. Illegal eviction means bedakhli. What used to happen that time, that these poor farmers, they used to take some land on rent and they used to do farming on that and then they used to take out profits from that. ठीक है, वो कुछ land को rent पे लेते थे, उस पर काम करते थे और उस पर अपना profit निकालते थे. And what happened, ये जो जमींदार थे, जो exploiters थे, they उनको जबरदस्ती बोलते थे that no, you just leave this land. Though they have paid the rent, उन्होंने rent भी pay किया होता था कि हमारा हक है यहाँ पे काम करना, but then also they were forced, that was known as illegal eviction. बेदखली बोलते थे उसको कि नहीं, you cannot enter this land. Though that they had paid the rent, but somehow peasants of Pratapgarh, they managed, उन्होंने manage कर दिया to stop illegal eviction, and the credit they gave to Gandhi ji. उन्होंने जितना भी क्रेडिट था वो गांधी जी को दे दिया कि व्हाट ऑल वी आर एबल टू डू दैट बिकॉज़ ऑफ गांधी जी, कि उनकी वजह से हम ये कर पाए. ट्राइबल्स एंड पीजेंट्स अंडरटूक एक्शंस दैट डिड नॉट कॉन्फॉर्म टू गांधीयन आइडल. सो गांधीयन आइडल वाज दैट नॉन वायलेंस, बट द पीपल दे मिसअंडरस्टूड इन अ डिफरेंट वेज. दे प्रोटेस्टेड, दे शोड नॉन कोऑपरेशन बट इन नॉन वायलेंट मींस, बट दैट वाज नॉट द बिलीव्स एंड आइडियाज ऑफ गांधी जी, व्हाट ही वांटेड. Okay, so what happened then? So people, they considered him as a god figure. उनको एक god figure की तरह पूछते थे लोग उस time पे. He was उनको title दे दिया महात्मा का, people's महात्मा. Okay, he is a great soul. He is a मसीहा. He is a savior. So what you can see in the picture, ऐसी pictures उस time पे बनाई गई जिसमें गांधी जी को एक savior की तरह बताया गया कि that he is the leader of this nationalist movement. ठीक है, उसको लीडर बताया. एंड यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर, ये सुभाष चंद्र बोस हैं, जवाहरलाल नेहरू. ओके, एंड दिस गॉड कृष्णा इज देयर. सो ही, महात्मा गांधी इज अ लीडर, ही इज लीडिंग द होल नेशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट, यू कैन से. सो दिस दिस रिस्पेक्ट वाज गिवन बाय द पीपल टू गांधी जी. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंड, सी इन द पिक्चर. In popular images too, Mahatma Gandhi is often shown as a divine. Divine means related to God. being occupying a place within the pantheon of Indian gods, jitne bhi Indian gods the. In this image, he is driving Krishna's chariot, guiding other nationalist leaders in the battle against the British. So this much respect he had gained that time by the Indian people. So, but actually they were not, though people respected Gandhiji, but they were not obeying him. Okay, unka method tha non-violence ka, but people somehow they misunderstood that this non-cooperation movement is to be done, but they were doing in their own manner. So what happened? One more incident came. Okay, so kya hua? Now see, I told you 1919 mein Rowlatt Act aayi thi, uske baad non-cooperation movement which was there in 1921-22 tak. Ab 1922 mein non-cooperation movement ko Gandhi ji ko band karna pada. Why? So what was the reason behind that? So reason was that what happened in February 1922. Okay, now again new period has started. So the happenings of in what we will study in this topic, that the happenings of 1922 to 29. In this period of time, isko hum truce period bolte hain, T-R-U-C-E. So this period is known as truce period. In that nothing remarkable movement koi aayi nahi, bahut badi movement koi nahi hui, but still they were on the agreement. Britishers or Indians ne agreement kar diye ki nahi, we will not adopt non-violent methods. So this was known as truce period, but still some of the happenings were there in this period that you must know. Okay, kya hua is period mein? So सबसे पहले बिगनिंग में 1922 में विच मूवमेंट वॉज गोइंग ऑन? नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट. बट गांधी जी, Mahatma Gandhi was against violent movement, so he abruptly called off the non-cooperation movement. उन्होंने बंद कर दिया non-cooperation movement को. Why? Because people were misunderstanding. उनको समझ में नहीं आ रहा था कि करना क्या है and what they wanted. So it turned out to be violent. Non-cooperation movement turned out to be violent. Why? How? What happened? In February 1922, a crowd of peasants, कुछ जो farmers थे, poor farmers का जो झुंड था, उन्होंने क्या किया? They set fire to a police station in Chauri Chaura. You must have heard also, पहले भी पढ़ा होगा lower classes में Chauri Chaura incident. Okay, so a crowd of peasants set fire to a police station in Chauri Chaura. Now this was not what Gandhi ji wanted. He wanted a peaceful movements. So what happened? जो इसमें जो लोग काम कर रहे थे, जो police officers थे, so they were also Indian. Though they were working under the British government, but still they were Indians. वो भी तो Indians थे ना. And Gandhi ji never wanted to kill any person in his movements. So that's why he called off this non-cooperation movement, because of this Chauri Chaura incident. What happened? Wherein the crowd of peasants set fire to a police station in Chauri Chaura, and 22 policemen were killed on that day. So this happened, and non-cooperation movement was stopped. ओके, सो अब क्या हुआ? नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट्स बंद कर दी उन्होंने. उसके बाद वो क्या चाहते थे? नाउ व्हाट गांधी जी वांटेड, ही वांटेड दैट द पीपल शुड बी रेडी, मींस द पीपल शुड बी ट्रेन्ड. उनको समझाया जाए नॉन वायलेंस एंड दे मस्ट बी सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट. ओके, इफ दे आर गेटिंग एक्सप्लॉयटेड बाय द लेबरर्स, देन दे शुड नॉट वर्क अंडर देम. दे शुड बी टॉट सम कंस्ट्रक्टिव वर्क. उनको कुछ ऐसी ट्रेनिंग दो कि वो अपना छोटा मोटा काम खुद शुरू कर सके. सो वॉट हैपन इन दिस पीरियड, द हैपनिंग्स ऑफ 1922 से लेकर 29 तक क्या हुआ? ड्यू टू दिस चौरी चौरा इंसिडेंट, देयर फोर गांधी जी फॉलोअर्स स्ट्रेस्ड दैट द कांग्रेस मस्ट अंडरटेक कंस्ट्रक्टिव वर्क इन द रूरल एरिया. की लोगों को कुछ ऐसा ट्रेनिंग देनी चाहिए, कुछ कंस्ट्रक्टिव वर्क सिखाना चाहिए, सो दैट दे शुड बिकम सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट एंड दे शुड नॉट बी एक्सप्लॉयटेड बाय द दिस जमींदार्स. ओके, सो दे शुड बी टॉट नॉन वायलेंस, दे शुड बी टॉट कंस्ट्रक्टिव वर्क, मींस दे शुड बी गिवन ट्रेनिंग. So now you have to keep on counting the points which happened in the happenings of 1922 and 29. First of all, training is training was given to rural people, and then leaders such as C.R. Das, Chittaranjan Das and Motilal Nehru argued that the party should fight elections to the councils. पहले इन्होंने मना कर दिया था 1919 में, so they said नहीं, we will not fight elections, we will not cooperate with you at all. But now they thought that they should fight elections, because if they will fight elections and they would win, so they will get a chance to enter into the British government, and if, when they will enter the British government, then they can come to know what is happening inside and what planning and strategies are going on inside the British government, so then they would be acting according to that. ठीक है. सो ये अब उनका एक स्ट्रेटेजी, न्यू स्ट्रेटेजी उन्होंने बनाई कि दैट दे शुड फाइट इलेक्शंस नाउ. सो बाय दिस टाइम दे वर गिवन द राइट टू फाइट द इलेक्शंस आल्सो. ओके इंडियंस. सो इन्होंने इलेक्शंस फाइट किए और जीते भी उस टाइम पे. ओके सी आर दास एंड मोतीलाल नेहरू. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड पॉइंट. फर्स्ट ट्रेनिंग वर्क दिया उनको. सेकेंड दे फाइट दे फॉट इलेक्शंस. एंड थर्ड इज सोशल वर्क. सोशल वर्क में क्या था, नाउ गांधी जी वॉन्टेड मोर एंड मोर पीपल टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश. अब मोर एंड मोर पीपल क्या थे, जो उस टाइम पे जो बैकवर्ड क्लास थी. ओके जो बैकवर्ड क्लासेस लाइक हु वर कंसिडर्ड अनटचेबल्स. सो दे वर नॉट ब्रॉट टू द फोरफ्रंट. दे वर नेवर कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड विद. दे वर नेवर अलाउड टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दीज मूवमेंट्स. सो गांधी जी वॉन्टेड टू एक्सटेंड देयर सपोर्ट बेस. सपोर्ट बेस मीन्स how many people are participating in this freedom struggle. So Gandhi ji brought these backward classes and untouchables into the forefront and they allowed him also participate. So that is called social work, working for the upliftment of the minorities, of the backward classes. So this social work was also done by the Gandhi ji that time. Okay, third point. First is training work, elections, social work. And then what happened, two important development also happened in the mid-19s. Mid-19s means 1924 or 25 May. So you can say two more political parties were formed. Sabse pehle, it was only Indian National Congress was there, in that moderates and extremists were working. But now two more political parties came into light, that is RSS and CPI. ठीक है. RSS is राष्ट्रीय स्वयंसेवक and CPI is Communist Party of India. Now these, it is not like that. I told you that we have not got freedom just because of one party or one person. It is the combined effort of so many parties and people who were involved in this movement. So these parties were also, but they had their own, sab parties ka alag alag perspective tha kaam karne ka. So these parties have held very different ideas about the kind of country India should be. Okay, like RSS were there, so they were Hindu party. So they believed in ancient Hinduism ko wo promote karte the aage. And CPI, they believed in Russian Revolution jisme wo peasants aur farmers ne overthrow kar diya tha Russian government ko. So ye jo mainly this party was of farmers and peasants. Okay, so these parties were also, but their main motive was only one, that to get rid of this British rule. So many parties combined together and they all worked together. So then revolutionary nationalist also came. This is very important word now. Revolutionary means krantikari. Nationalist means rashtravadi. ठीक है. So जो अपने राष्ट्र के लिए लड़ने वाले लोग थे. And in this we cannot forget or we cannot neglect the working of Bhagat Singh. So Bhagat Singh too was active in this period. So we will read the story of Bhagat Singh also. So these all things happened during this truce period. 1922 से लेके 29 तक कोई movement नहीं आई, but all these things happened. What happened? Gandhi ji he made the people ready for the more you can say for the next movement which he wanted to. That उसके बाद जो 1930 में civil disobedience movement आई थी, ठीक है? So he gave training work to the people. He made him understand that non-violence method should be there. Then they fought elections also. Social work was done by Gandhi ji. Then two important political parties came, RSS or CPI, and revolutionary nationalists. Like Bhagat Singh too was active in this period. So what happened during this truce period at the end of decade? At the end of decade means 1929 May. Congress demanded Purn Swaraj, complete independence. So इन्होंने you can say they declared that we want complete independence, and it was declared in the Lahore session, and this session was under the presidentship of Jawaharlal Nehru. ठीक है. यहाँ पे इन्होंने declare कर दिया that we want complete independence. We will not cooperate in any way. ऐसा भी नहीं है कि आप लोग Britishers, they are ruling on our head and we are working under them, or we are able to participate and they are also, we will not, means not incomplete or partial. We want complete independence, Purn Swaraj, that you must leave India and leave India on our own, and we will take care of our India. Okay, so they demanded Purn Swaraj. So what happened, this Bhagat Singh came into light that time, and during this period the Simon Commission also came. Truce period mein Simon Commission bhi aayi thi. Now what is the Simon Commission, understand? So in 1927 the British government in England decided to send a commission headed by Lord Simon to decide India's political future. अब ये हमारा इंडिया का पॉलिटिकल फ्यूचर भी डिसाइड करेंगे. ओके, नाउ यू विल से कि मैम ये कौन होते हैं हमारा पॉलिटिकल फ्यूचर डिसाइड करने वाला. सेम थिंग हैपेंड, यू नो द फीलिंग जब हमें पता लगता है वी आर कमिंग टू नो ऑल दीस थिंग्स, सो आवर ब्लड स्टार्ट्स बॉइलिंग. सेम वे दैट टाइम द इंडियंस वर ऑल्सो इन द सेम कंडीशन. सो वेन दे केम टू नो दैट वन कमीशन इज कमिंग फ्रॉम इंग्लैंड टू डिसाइड इंडियाज पॉलिटिकल फ्यूचर, एंड Moreover, there was no Indian representative in that commission. Ki India ka political future decide karenge, but without any Indian representative. So obviously the Indians would be enraged. So the commission had no Indian representative and the decision created an outrage in India. Ki logon ko bahut gussa aaya ki that they are coming to decide India's political future and without the involvement of any Indian representative. So then we are very sorry that we will not support this. So then what happened? All the political groups, jitni bhi political parties thi, they decided to boycott the commission. Unhone boycott kiya commission ko. They did not let them do their work. And when the commission arrived, it was met with demonstrations with banners saying, Simon, go back. You must have heard also about this Simon, go back. So inhone dharne kiye, protest kiye. And what was the outcome? That this Simon commission was a failure. It was not able to establish its power in India. So it was a failure. But in this, protest, in these demonstrations, so lathi charge was done by the Britishers. So when the people were revolting, so lathi charge was done by the Britishers. And in that lathi charge, Lala Lajpat Rai was died. Okay, he died in that lathi charge. Now, ab Lala Lajpat Rai's lathi charge mein jab mar gaye, so then Bhagat Singh, who was in his party, so they decided to take revenge from the British government. So that's why they were more into the non-violent methods, because if the Britishers are practicing non-violence, that why would they not practice non-violence? So that's why there was a conflict between Mahatma Gandhi and Bhagat Singh. So both of their mode of struggle were different. So what was the story of Bhagat Singh? Let us try to read that also a little bit. So you know that they threw a bomb in the Legislative Assembly. Okay, and when they threw the bomb also, and along with that bomb, it was not to kill any people. It was just to create that fear that if you can try non-violence, that we can also do. But in that bomb, nobody was killed. And along with that, they threw leaflets also. Unhone leaflets bhi throw kiye the. And what was written on that leaflet? It was, it takes a loud voice to make the deaf hear in Kalab Zindabad. So उन leaflets पे ये लिखा हुआ था कि तुम लोगों को समझ में नहीं आता, Britishers were deaf, कि वो बहरे हो गए थे कि तुम लोगों को कि जब समझ में नहीं आता ना कि इनकलाब जिंदाबाद, so then we have to do these kind of explosions, कि ऐसे धमाके करके बम फोड़ के तुम लोगों को सुनाना पड़ता है, जो बहरे लोग होते हैं उनको सुनाई नहीं देता इनकलाब जिंदाबाद. So then that's why they threw the bomb and they threw this leaflet, which was on that it was written, it takes a loud voice to make the deaf hear in Kalab Zindabad. So he was a revolutionary. And who were the other person with him? Revolutionary nationalists such as Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Sukhdev and others wanted to fight against the colonial rule and the rich exploiting classes through a revolution of workers and peasants. So these all people were there with him, and the rich exploiting classes also, the zamindars were there who were exploiting the poor farmers. They were also with the Britishers. So they all were fighting against them. So who founded, then one association was formed जिनमें ये भगत सिंह और ये काम करते थे. So इनकी एक association थी, that was known as HSRA. So what was this association? This association was formed by Chandrasekhar Azad. ठीक है, ये actually बहुत पहले form हो गई थी 1921-22 में, but that time it was not too active. So it became active when this Simon Commission came, and then after that it became active. So Chandrasekhar Azad founded this Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. Okay, you need to know the full form, HSRA, Hindustan Socialist Republic Association, in 1928 at Firoz Shah Kotla in Delhi. में ये उन्होंने association found की, और इनमें ये लोग काम करते थे, Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Rajguru. So what happened? So I told you that during that Simon Commission revolt, during the lathi charge, who was killed? Lala Lajpat Rai was killed during that. And this Bhagat Singh, they wanted to take revenge from the Britishers who killed Lala Lajpat Rai. Now he was killed in the Lathi charge. So, but then who ordered that Lathi charge? कौन से British official ने Lathi charge को order किया था? So then what happened? On 17 December 1928, Bhagat Singh, Azad and Rajguru assassinated Saunders. So they killed Saunders. उन्होंने Saunders को गोली मार दी. But actually this was a mistake. He did not want to kill Saunders. He wanted to kill James Scott. Who was James Scott? James Scott was the leader of this, who gave the order for the Lathi charge. जिसने Lathi charge का order दिया था, वो James Scott था. They wanted to kill James Scott, but mistakenly they killed Saunders. So Saunders, no doubt, he was also involved. So Saunders was a police officer who was involved in the Lathi charge. So he was there in the Lathi charge that has caused the death of Lala Lajpat Rai. But actually the order of Lathi charge was given by the officer that was James Scott. Okay, so then what happened? So when this Saunders was killed by the Bhagat Singh, Azad and Rajguru, Britishers were enraged, unko gussa aa gaya. So now to show their power, what they did, they started killing innocent people. They started, they ordered Lathi charge on innocent people. Unhone matlab innocent logo pe aur zyada atrocities shuru kar diye, theek hai? And they passed more strict bills, bahut zyada strict bills unhone pass kar diye the that could more taxes and you can say more atrocities on the poor people, means without any reason. So tab ye Bhagat Singh ko laga ki hamari wajah se the innocent people are being killed. Okay, so actually they were blaming themselves ki humne mara na Saunders ko, to hame saza do, why you are killing innocent people? So Britishers were doing that because they were giving the punishment of Bhagat Singh to the innocent people. So that's why Bhagat Singh, Azad and Rajguru, they threw bomb in the legislative assembly to get arrested. That if we have done wrong, give the punishment to us, not to innocent people. Ki unko mat punishment do, hame do. So that's why on 8th April 1929, Bhagat Singh and Batukeshwar Dutt, you must have watched the movies, aapne dekhi hongi. Have you watched the movies on Bhagat Singh? Who has watched?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So many movies are there, and you can see that you know, while they are getting trialed in the court, what kind of attitude they hold. किस attitude में वो जवाब देते हैं, and ये they tell the procedure also to how to make a bomb also. वो पूरा procedure बता देते हैं, bomb कैसे बनाते हैं, and they all can make the bomb then. So that you must watch these movies. ठीक है, Legend of Bhagat Singh हो गया. So उसमें मतलब very nicely they have shown that what kind of attitude, what bravery and valor they had, Bhagat Singh and his team. So Bhagat Singh and B.K. Dutt, Batukeshwar Dutt, threw a bomb in the Central Legislative Assembly. उन्होंने bomb फेंक दिया. So reason यही था कि हमारा अगर हमने कुछ किया है तो हमें सजा दो. Don't kill innocent people. So that's why they wanted to get arrested and they threw the bomb in the assembly. The aim, as the leaflet explained, so unka aim kya tha? Jo leaflet pe likha tha was not to kill. Unko marna, unka ye maksad nahi tha ki humne bomb fenka hai kisi ko marne ke liye. No. But to make the deaf hear that and to remind the foreign government of its callous exploitation, means what they were doing with the innocent people. Callous means insensitive, cruel behavior, what they were doing with the innocent people. So they must stop that. So they wanted the Britishers to hear that they wanted to make the deaf hear Inqilab Jindabad. So then Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Rajguru were executed on March 23, 1931. So can you tell me the age? What time, his age was of Bhagat Singh?
23.
And yes, he was
23.
So you can see, you can imagine that at a very young age, he got what kind of, you know, beliefs were there and what kind of passion he had for his nation. So he just did it and there was no any selfishness in that. They were so much, you can say their mindset was like that, they were ready to sacrifice their lives for the nation. ठीक है, वो अपने आप को
was of 22
करता था. Yes
ma'am, Rajguru was of 22.
Okay, and can you tell me who, any more young man who got sacrificed? Punjab se ek aur hai,
17 age.
Punjab
se ek aur hai, 17 age.
Yes, who was that at 17?
Khudiram Bose. मैम खुदीराम बोस मैम इन 17 एज फॉर
एट 17 मे बी ही इज बट वन मोर फ्रॉम पंजाब वाज देयर करतार सिंह सराभा हैज एनीवन हर्ड ऑफ दिस नेम ओके so that's why you can say that the people from why you know they say that you now also that in the farmers protest in Delhi so it was only the Punjab who took initiative na who went to the protest and they protested they are still there so you can see that what kind of situation is there that now so why it is only in the blood of Punjabis only that they are so hot blooded so nobody took the initiative na koi bhi nahi gaya wahan pe sirf mostly punjab farmers are there in delhi and by seeing them now other farmers have joined rajasthan ke haryana ke mp ke they have joined but first the initiative was taken by the punjab only so you can say this is in the blood of the punjab that they cannot bear the this kind of any kind of exploitation they cannot bear okay and they know how to write how to fight for their rights so we should be proud of that we are in india and we are in punjab and we have this kind of strong history behind us fine so this is all about bhagat singh so tomorrow we will study about the dandi march clear so meeting is